There are 7 billion people on the planet, and we're all on different paths.
Namaste.
Some of us are on the road to being financially successful, and some of us are looking for the perfect relationship. Others seek a specific place to live. But in reality, we're all looking for the same thing. We all want happiness, ananda, so that we can find contentment, santosha. In yoga, they say we are spiritual beings having a material experience and not the other way around. That we are pure spirit or soul inhabiting a temporary material body. So we tend to think material objects will fill that gap, hole, lacuna, or missing piece in our lives. We want to fill that void with cars, money, possessions, etc., in the hopes that we will cure our emptiness. It isn't until we realize that we are spiritual beings and the only thing that can satisfy the soul is to put in a natural environment of being spiritual through meditation, reflection, and sacred activities. No one wants to be fake. Everyone wants to be real. But in our modern Western society, it's hard not to be superficial. How do we become real? How do we become genuine? We have to work from the inside out and not the outside in. It is imperative that we seek the profound, ontological, metaphysical questions of life, of who we are, what our purpose is, and why do we exist, and to seek out the answers. This will help us become the person we strive for, to become genuine, and to find our destiny. We think the physical poses are intense or difficult, but that is only a small hill compared to the mountain of having to climb over your false ego, bad habits, things we need to change. All the internal struggles and changes that we need to address in order to be truly happy. Yoga is a lifestyle, not just an hour on a rubber mat. It is physical, dietary, philosophical, and unifying. The word yoga means to yoke or unite with God through dhyana or meditation. In reality, the poses were created to open the body, tone the muscles, so that you could sit for long periods of time without having to dwell on a stiff back, a kink in your neck, or congestion in your thought process, so that you're free to explore the deeper, soulful questions of life and are able to relink with your eternal soulmate. The question is not how do we find the meaning of life, but rather, when are we going to start looking?